Hello, I'm Mike with this week's new and trending AI tools you can't afford to miss. Coming up, we'll revisit some of my favorite videos from nearly a year ago, building a full app with AI and building mobile apps with AI. How have the tools improved in the last 8 or 9 months? Starting with this video where I built Comment Genie, a little app to help me respond to YouTube comments. Seeing as I'm watching all the changes across AI 3 days ago, that's right, just recently, in a Zapier changelog, I noticed that they introduced a new trigger for YouTube, which is new comment on video. And that got me to thinking, could I use AI orchestration to create my first AI employee that will respond to comments on this very video? Yes, if you use the word magic anywhere in your comment on this video, my AI employee will respond to you. Let's go ahead and build that employee right now inside Zapier Agents. We'll add an agent like this. Every time a new comment is posted on my YouTube video that contains the word magic, continue with this automation. If it doesn't contain the word magic, stop this automation. When you continue, I'd like you to do a Google search for the content of that comment and then also search the web to find some relevant reply that you can give. Once you've got your information, reply in 1 to 2 sentences, keep it very brief and concise and friendly, and use a little bit of humor to make the person who posted the comment laugh. There's my prompt. I'll click Create Agent. And this is really exciting because what cost me a lot of coding time using AI coding tools is now being done for me in a matter of seconds using natural language. And I like it. First of all, it's given it a name. Let's just call that Magic Comment Replies. That'll be perfect for my first AI employee working on this video. So, first of all, we need to add a trigger, and we'll search for YouTube here. Now we'll select New Comment on Video. This is brand new. 3 days ago, this trigger wasn't available inside Zapier. Now it is, and this gives me superpowers. So with that done, I need to select a video ID. Now, even with my mind reading skills, I can't tell you what the ID on this video is going to be yet. So I'll use another video to test my AI employee and see how it does. I'll go back to my channel, I'll sort by latest, and I'll just copy the ID to my latest video, which will be this long string at the end here. Let's copy that, go back to the Zapier Agents interface, paste that ID in, and click save. Now you can see here after the trigger, the instructions are really easy to understand. Even a human can read them. Check if the text contains magic. If it does, proceed to step 3. If not, stop the workflow. Perform a Google search. And this is the point we'll insert another tool. Yes, that's absolutely right. It's amazing. We can Google search with our AI employee. Then perform a web search to formulate a reply. Again, we click visit website and give the AI employee that tool. Using this information gathered from the searches, generate a reply that is 1 to 2 sentences long, brief, concise, friendly, and includes humor. And then step 6 is to post the reply back to the YouTube comment. Okay, fantastic. We're going to need to insert one more tool here, and it will be a YouTube tool. So we'll search for YouTube here. And in order to post a reply, we're going to need to select API request. Now, don't get scared by this. If you can copy and paste a few things, you can get comment replies working. Click the cog and set these settings just as I do. And don't worry, I'll post a link down below with the details of what I've set up if you want to copy and paste. Stop on error should be use default. HTTP method should be set a specific value, and it should be post. URL should be specific, and I'll paste in this URL from the YouTube API. Query string parameters again should be specific. We'll add one. The key is part, and the value is snippet. Next up, additional request headers. Yes, you guessed it. You set the value for that. You add one. The key is content type, and the value is application/JSON. And finally, for the body, we let the agent generate a value for this field, as the agent will decide the reply it would like to post to the comment. We'll save. Now we just need to make one update here. In the body part of this tool, you need to make sure to post JSON exactly as shown in the example, but replacing the comment ID for the new comment you found from the trigger and the reply that you've just generated, making sure that the JSON is escaped. Okay, I'm feeling pretty good about this. Let's test the agent and see if it works. Okay, it's testing the behavior and it's searching for a comment on my video. It's found one. It says the comment does not contain the word magic, so no reply will be posted. And let's read the comment it found, which was actually my pinned comment, build your own AI assistant with Zapier Agents. Okay, that's great. The agent noticed the keyword magic wasn't in the comment, so didn't do anything further. That's expected behavior, but let's test it and actually see if we can get it to post a reply autonomously on my behalf. So I can see in this comment text the word Zapier is there, so let's copy it and just swap out the word magic for Zapier in the agent's instructions here, and we'll retest the agent to see if we can get a reply posted. Now, I want you to note that it's found this particular comment here actually posted by me on the Creator Magic YouTube channel, but as you can see, no replies as of yet. So now we'll go back, we'll retest with the trigger word Zapier and see if this agent actually posts a reply. So it searched for the comment, and again, it's found that same Zapier comment, and now it said I'll perform a Google search, and it's doing it, and it's looking for all things about Zapier agents, funnily enough. And now it's finding the contents of the URL in the comment, which is insane, actually. It's looking at this website, now it's completed its web browsing, and it's thinking what to respond with. Okay, and it's found something, and it says it's already created the JSON, which is correct, and it's proceeding to post the reply to this YouTube comment. Now, of course, only while you're testing the agent and not when the agent goes live, you need to manually approve tasks. But when you click to set your agent live, yes, this will be done autonomously, even while you sleep. And now it is trying to access the ability to post the comment, and it says reply posted successfully. And now let's scroll down and look at this. One reply on my pinned comment. And what is it? Zapier Agents, the only butler who never asks for a coffee break and automates while you sleep with a robot arm. Thanks for sharing. My AI is already jealous. Oh, this is fantastic. Now all that's left to do is replace the keyword with magic, so magic will trigger my autonomous AI employee, and then we'll switch it on to be enabled. So as you can see, building with AI is getting more and more powerful every single day, meaning you can have AI employees working for you 24/7, even while you sleep or you're on vacation. It's the core of AI orchestration and the subject of my brand new full-length course called AI Employees. In this course, I will show you how to build an entire team of AI agents that can monitor your competitors, qualify your sales leads, and even run your social media marketing, all with no code using Zapier Agents. Now, this full-length course is launching for my premium Creator Magic members later this month. But if you can't wait that long and you're a premium member already, or you join before the end of the weekend, go here to Premium Discussion and find the post, "Want early access to my AI employees course," and comment, "Let's go." I'll give you early access on Monday. You can see a lot of people have done so already. And hey, if you want to test out the AI employee I just built, comment down below and use the word magic. That's the trigger word that will wake my AI employee up. And whatever you ask it, it will go out, do a quick Google search, find a few websites, and then respond to you in a rather humorous way. The best comment down below that gets the most likes will get a free month of premium in Creator Magic. So go ahead and post the word magic, followed by your question, down below. Next up this week, I'm going back to my popular videos and looking at the iOS app and Android app tutorials I made 7 or 8 months ago. Coding a full mobile app with absolutely no code. I wanted to revisit this week and see if it's got any easier. And this was triggered by Amjad Masad's appearance on the Joe Rogan Experience this week.
AI is like a massive remixing machine. It can remix all the information it learned.
Amjad Masad, one of the brightest minds in AI and CEO of AI coding tool Replit, put me on the edge of my seat when Joe Rogan questioned him about human creativity.
I think that's creativity, for sure.
And that's a uniquely human characteristic? For now?
For now?
Yeah, I didn't like the hesitation there. Make hay now, my friends. Make hay now. Let's get into Replit for iOS and Android apps. Now, Replit is actually trending this week because just earlier this week on Tuesday, they announced Dynamic Intelligence. This is the ability to choose extended thinking or a higher powered model or even web search. It's kind of similar to the agent mode that Lovable introduced, and I did a dedicated video on that earlier this week. So now we've got all these new tools available to us, and I noticed after logging into my Replit account after a long time away, I've referred quite a few people, and it's also given me some bonus credits to play with. So if you've got any ideas on an app I could build in the future using these credits, drop it down below and add the word magic so my AI employee can verify your idea. Now, I was checking out their docs, and Matt Palmer, who's the head of developer relations, has made some great tutorials on creating apps with Replit. It seems to be way easier now to make a mobile app for iOS or Android using a tool like Replit. So I'm going to give it a go with one of my biggest hits, the legendary Tide Times app. So when you've signed up for Replit, and I'll link that down below, you just need to find this expo template that I'll also put in the documentation below, and you just remix it to get started. We'll give it a name, Super Tide Times, and we'll give it a description. This is a mobile app that will find the local tide times for your area and present them with a beautiful graph. I'm going with a private repository here, and I'm going to use the template. Okay, we're all set. Before I do anything, I'm going to click run and test this out. Now you'll see it's installed a bunch of packages, it's given me a QR code to scan, and it's just finishing up down here. Let's wait for that to complete. Okay, we seem to be ready. Preview of the mobile app is here in the preview tab, and I've got the Replit app installed, which is really cool for working on the go, and Expo Go, which I'm going to need to make this work. First of all, I'm going to open up my camera, and then I'm going to scan that QR code. That is then going to open up the project right inside my iPhone. Look at this. It's actually building it on my iPhone. And eventually, we'd be able to bundle this and upload it to something like the App Store and publish it in the future. Now, within moments, look at that. We've got a mirror image of what's over here in my web browser on my iPhone. I can click the Explore tab and I can see what is in Explore. I can click the Home tab on my iPhone and access that. Now, let's prompt the Replit Assistant and see what kind of mobile app we can build in just a few prompts. I would like you to use this template to build me a really cool Tide Times app. It's called Super Tide Times. It will give me a search box and I can search for different locations around the world and then get the live tide times for that area. It will be presented in a really beautiful graph on screen with some boxes below showing low and high tide times precisely. Make it look really beautiful, use Apple design principles. And there's my prompt, and you'll notice I'm on advanced mode here for the Replit Assistant. Let's hit enter, and I'm really excited to see what gets built. Okay, here it's going to work. Now it's asking to install some dependencies, so we'll absolutely approve that. It's creating everything that's needed here. You'll notice as it's going along, it's using Claude 4.0 Sonnet, so we've got a much upgraded model since I last created a mobile app on my channel. It also says the assistant automatically restarted my app, so let's refresh. Oh my goodness me. Wow. What took me 8 minutes has taken me 30 seconds 8 months later. Now, I've just exited out of Expo Go, and I'm going to click back into the app, and then you'll see Expo on Replit. That's my live project. Let's click that on the screen, let it open up, and wow, here is my Super Tide Times app. In one shot, one prompt, I've got the highs and lows here for San Francisco. I can click locations in the bottom right, and look at this. San Francisco is favorited, Monterey Bay in California. This is totally insane. Let's type into the search box, Laguna Beach, and then hit search. And yeah, it seems to have updated the location to Laguna Beach, but what it doesn't seem to have done is updated the tide times. They seem to have remained the same, which indicates while it's a working prototype, it's not actually calling a tide times API to get the data. Let's see if my next prompt can fix that inside Replit. Okay, well done. You've done incredibly well for a first prototype, but I don't think you're pulling in live data. So can you use a free API to get tide times? And rather than present me with a search box, just give me a list of locations I can click on to immediately switch the graph and tide times to that location. There's my prompt. Let's hit enter. And immediately my assistant is going to work. It says it's working on it, and it's actually going to use the NOAA Tides and Currents API, which is free and provides real tide data. We're going to apply this. Look at this. I've got all of these locations, and on my iPhone, I can scroll left to right, and we can go for Boston, and we can get the live tide data for Boston, maybe New York, and look at this. It's loading from NOAA live data. Now, what I don't like when I scroll down is it's showing me low, 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 too much data there. It's kind of gone and ruined that, hasn't it? So one more prompt for the charm, and let's make it look pretty and tie a bow on top of this app. Okay, you've done incredibly well, and I'm definitely going to give you a banana, but to put the icing on the cake, I'd only like to show the low and high times, not all the times in a list, and I'd like you to make the app look even more beautiful using gradients and lovely emojis and just make it really warm and friendly. We'll hit enter to that, and at this stage, I really am vibe coding. That was a pretty quick update, and now it's showing the lowest tide, and we move to Los Angeles. And yes, we've got lowest tide at a different time. This all seems to be pretty accurate and working now. If you like what you see so far, throw a like, subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. I'm really happy with that, And it's definitely the future of app development. You can use this on iOS and Android. And when you want to publish the app that you create with Replit, there is a pathway to do that too. So go and test Replit out yourself. Let me know what kind of app you're working on down in the comments below. And add the word magic if you want my AI employee to respond. All right, finally, my favorite OP AI code editor, Cursor, has just released 1.2, and it's getting a lot of love on the X platform. You can now make changes on web and mobile using Cursor agents. And this is pretty cool because my mobile is now a vibe coding powerhouse where I can actually talk to my Cursor agent on the move. And this is really cool because I can now vibe code on the bus, make my mobile app better, and then spin a Cursor agent off to make the change, put a merge request into my Git repo, and I can merge it when I get home. They've also added pull request search and indexing, and also, most notably, to-do lists. Claude Code has had this for a while, but Cursor now has it, and it's caused a big flurry of excitement on X, so let me test it out. Click continue, we'll get rid of my terminal windows because I've been experimenting with Claude Code with my Ship Your App cohort, and we'll go into the chat box right here. So let's give the to-do list a go. We'll try a complex task for this, such as implement user authentication on my app. Now we'll let it go to work. It's planning the next moves. It's looking at my app. And now look at this, updating to-do list. There we go. We've got a nice set of 8 to-dos. This is really cool. So that means that it's going through all the to-dos and we can view all at any point and see exactly where Cursor is on its progress. This means Cursor gets way more organized as it goes through and ticks things off as it's done. It doesn't hallucinate, get lost, and hopefully this reduces the endless loops that Cursor and other AI coding tools can get stuck in. Updating to-do list, look at this in just one call. It's already done 3 on the to-do list, such as setting up authentication, creating a users table, creating authentication routes. It's now implementing the middleware to protect the routes, and it will continue until it creates the user dashboard to view their history in my app. Pretty cool stuff, and now those quality of life improvements in Cursor 1.2 mean I need to do less thinking, and my AI coding tool does the work for me. Let me know what you think of the tools in this week's video. And remember, if you want my AI employee to respond to you, use the word magic in your comment down below. Hopefully, I'll see you in the premium section of my community. If you like what you've seen, remember to like and subscribe. I do videos like this weekly. Thank you so much for watching. As you can probably guess, I really enjoy doing these weekly updates. And YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks. Oh, and by the way, in the time it's taken me to close this video, the to-do list now in Cursor has pretty much finished.